What is up, my aesthetic boys? It's Fresh, back with another video, some classic r/choosing beggars, and I, yes, me, myself, am about to tell you why God is gonna smite Eastern Canada. Would you trade it for a riding mower? You can pick it up in League City. Hello, if I understand correctly, you would like to trade a riding mower for a $19,000 car, and we will have to come pick up the mower? Yes. That's correct. Is it made of gold? No, it's red. Well, that's weird. Why would they make an entire riding mower out of gold just to cover it in red paint? It makes no sense to me. Please, this is my parents' house. I'm trying to fix it for them. Well, let them know $39.99 an hour, which is my reduced rate for friends. I usually charge $69.99 per hour residential and $89.99 per hour business. Lol. What? You cray, dude. No thanks, I'll find someone who wants to help someone instead of looking at them like dollar sign. I mean, that is my profession. I survive by doing technical support for people. Why would I give away my services for free? God is commanding me to tell my husband's family that you failed the test to save my life, and because of that, God is about to pour out wrath on the earth any moment. I know this with all my gut because God is approaching me about how it is so close to God judging my enemies in my own city, and God told me clearly that after God poured out wrath on my city, that God was going to pour out wrath on Eastern Canada next. You will see God pour out this wrath, and God will want you to know that you are the cause of God shaking the entire earth right now over willfully disobeying your conscience to save my life. The entire world will know that you wanted me dead, and it will be one of the strongest judgments God has ever poured out over the earth. You will all be shaking in fear of God. In my dreams, this wrath was so heavy that people were caught in rubble all over, and it was earthquake after earthquake after earthquake until my life was saved. You are not able to know God's wrath is about to be poured out because you are wicked, and God won't let you hear his voice. But that will be no excuse to have not prepared to escape the wrath of God, because I warned you God's wrath was about to be poured out. None of you will be shaking your fist at me any longer when God shakes this earth and the entire world knows how God feels about people that want me dead. This wrath was so heavy that newscasters and politicians were vomiting and saying, "What is going on?" God wants you to know that as I sit here knowing that I am so close to my death, that God is about to shake the earth over it. God is going to make sure the world knows that God's wrath will not stop until my life is saved. I would not be posting how close it is to God's wrath being poured out if I was not absolutely sure God makes his prophets understand how close it is to God pouring out wrath. To my in-laws, your city will go up as the city that God sends an earthquake to that never got earthquakes before all to show as a sign of why God has started his wrath. Because if you had saved my life, then God would not need to use your city as a sign of his judgment on why God is pouring out his wrath. The wicked rich grandfather will be ashamed in front of the entire world, and God will make sure that the world knows he cast that rich man in hell and blames that rich man and many other rich men like him for all this suffering in the world, because they are guilty of murder by leaving helpless people on the street to die. This unfortunately sounds like the incoherent ramblings of someone in a severe state of mental destitution, and I genuinely hope they receive the help they need. Anyway, I doubt Eastern Canada would be God's target if he really were to smite part of the earth. Ugh, that's all I get for walking the dog. Hashtag rich, hashtag money, hashtag for you page, hashtag for you, hashtag FYP, which stands for you page, hashtag phone, hashtag Android, and they show a picture of a 2013 Moto X, which to be fair in 2019 must be kind of slow, but what phone are they using to take the picture of the 2013 Moto X? Probably something more recent than that. Also, and very importantly, my dog has never given me sh** for walking him, so count yourself very lucky, young man. Someone plug me their Disney Plus account still. I won't pay you, but you will have a friend for life. Now, if lifetime friendship with you only costs $7 a month, I'd be concerned about the quality of friendship, honestly. I was wondering if there may be a reward. A reward for what, you may ask, dear listener? Well, a reward for stealing OP's phone. The person texting them, I kid you not, stole their phone, and this is the conversation that ensued. It is a very expensive phone, and I could have unlocked it myself, but I thought I wouldn't want that to happen to me, and if I lost my phone like that, I'd pay someone to have it and return it. I just want to be the nice guy this time. I even broke my phone today finding your mom's phone, and it is an iPhone 2. Or if she wants to sell it, I'll give her $150 for it cash if she unlocks it for me. Well, I can discuss this with her. Is there a specific amount you have in mind? I don't know. It'll cost me $80 to fix my phone, and well, if she wants to not get her phone, ask her if she would like to take off the Find My iPhone and make it so that I can use the phone up to her. I am not normally the type of person that would return something like this. I would just sell it to some stranger and get the money, but it is close to Christmas time. Here are your options. 1. Come get phone. Help me pay for my phone to be fixed. 2. Let me keep phone and unlock it for me with giving me the info I need to reset it, iCloud account and password. Or 3, come let me pay you $150 cash after you unlock the phone for me and do factory reset in front of me. Please let me know ASAP, I have to work at 6 p.m. Right, I mean the guy's being, he's being charitable, reasonable to say the least. He gave you 3 options, 1, he can scam you, 2, he can scam you, and 3, now get this, he can scam you. Hey, Redacted, do you have Netflix?
Yeah. Why?
I wanted to use it.
No.
Wow, thanks. F*** you. For all the sacrifices we did and you can't share your Netflix for one day. Shows your true color. I didn't mean to send that to you, but anyway. Thanks. You just slapped me in the face. I'm raging mad.
Nice to meet you, raging mad. I'm fresh.
Crazy Karen at Starbucks gets kicked out in all caps. Yeah, it kind of seems like a classic Reddit clickbait kind of title, but let's read on, we'll find out. This isn't my first post here, and I'm sure it won't be my last. I'm deaf and have been since I was 12. From then on, I learned sign language and really focused on learning how to lip read because all my friends were hearing. Our story begins a couple days ago when me and a good friend of mine, known each other for over 10 years, were in line at Starbucks. Honestly, I was pretty nervous, as most of the time I just use mobile order because it's a lot less pressure on me and it's less time consuming for the barista. But of course, today, my phone had died. Lucky, I had a friend with me to calm me down. There was a pretty long line, but we didn't mind and we just signed while we waited for our turn when I see the lady in front of us at the counter. I can tell she's angry as she's throwing her hands up in the air, but of course she's facing away from me, so I don't get to know all the juice. I asked my friend to sign what she was saying so I could gossip with her. So she starts interpreting, and here's what went down. EP, you are honestly the worst cashier I have ever met. Where is your manager? Today's your last day at work, and I'm gonna make sure of it. I'll be right back, just let me go get my manager for you. In the meantime, just step right over here so these two ladies can get through. The barista turns around and leaves when the EP looks back at me and my friend. Of course. Starbucks is always something I didn't understand, yet I am always put last. Me, I'm sorry I can't hear you, I'm deaf. I said this while signing. EP, so you're gonna serve a... See, I'm not gonna say this word. Look, this word hurts people, and if you don't think it does, ask around. That's the John Boy's rhetoric and I'm sticking to it. Over me. I've been waiting longer and they should really serve the normal people first. She said something after that, but I was so shocked that I stopped reading her lips. My friend said, are you kidding me? She's just deaf and she deserves just as much respect as you. Don't start calling her abnormal just because you can't f***ing hear you. I will say that word, but I will bleep it too. The manager came in from the back to calm everyone down. EP apparently told the manager I was throwing up gang signs when her friend told him, she's f***ing deaf. What do you want from her, lady? At least she said lady this time. And then the EP went off on the cashier for, quote, attempting to have other people cut her in line. Entitled parent was asked to leave, and my friend and I got our drinks for free. And man, did it feel good to wave at that bitch while she was huffing in her car with my free coffee. To be clear, I had my free coffee and I was waving at her. She was huffing without free coffee. Clarifying that. Yeah, it seems a little grandiose, maybe it seems a little embellished, but having personally seen the way some people treat others with disabilities, I unfortunately see the situation as both plausible and obviously downright disturbing. It really just comes down to fairly basic human decency, a concept this particular Karen is severely deficient in.